In the following minutes, we're going to have Christina, and she's going to read the press release.
Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, thank you for coming. Our purpose here for gathering today in front of the Royal Norwegian General Consulate is to stand in solidarity with the family of Marius and Ruth Bodnarie. Recent international press articles that have covered this case both in Norway and abroad have contained certain misinterpreted and inaccurately documented information surrounding this family. I will rectify these statements with a detailed explanation of the family itself and the events that have taken place since November 16th. Marius and Ruth Bodnarie have been living in Norway for the past 10 years. Their children, including 9-year-old Eliana, 7-year-old Naomi, 5-year-old Matthew, 2-year-old John, and 3-month-old Ezekiel, were all born in Norway and also hold Romanian citizenship. Marius Bodnarie has a master's degree in computer systems engineering and applied informatics from Bucharest Polytechnic University, and works in Naustdal as the IT lead responsible for the entire school district of the city. The district includes 10 communities and 50 schools. Ruth is a registered nurse who works in the pediatric ward of the Nord Central Hospital. In mid-November 2015, the Viering school principal of the middle school that was attended by Eliana and Naomi made a phone call to Norwegian Child Protective Services, known as Barnevernet, to express her concerns regarding the girls' religious upbringing. She believed that the girls were being disciplined at home and felt that their parents and grandmother were radical Christians. She was of the opinion that these religious beliefs were inhibiting the girls' development. Although she made clear to Barnevernet that she did not believe that the girls were being physically abused at home, the principal stressed that Barnevernet's counseling services were required to rectify this problem. Without a single investigation, without any psychosocial or emotional assessments made of the children, Barnevernet's response was to file a claim that alleged family violence committed by the parents. Marius and Ruth were never informed of these charges. On November 16th, Barnevernet initiated the confiscation of the Bodnarie children and arrested Marius and Ruth. The girls were taken from school and the two older boys were forcefully removed from the family home. Ruth was arrested in front of her children, and Marius was publicly arrested at work. Both parents were separately escorted to the local police station for interrogation. Marius, who is not a Norwegian citizen, was not provided with a lawyer or a translator throughout the entire duration of his interrogation. After a few hours of harsh interrogation, the police discharged the parents together with the still breastfeeding baby Ezekiel. The police had concluded that the parents were not dangerous and told both Marius and Ruth that they would receive follow-up communication explaining what would happen. The children were placed in 3 separate foster homes. I'd like to reiterate here, there wasn't a single investigation into the psychosocial or emotional assessments made of the children. The parents were illegally arrested by authorities as they were not informed of the allegations or evidence that warranted such extreme aggressions. Furthermore, Marius and Ruth were coerced into complying without legal counsel. They were assured that their cooperation in this matter would result in a positive outcome for their family. The following day, however, on November 17th, contrary to the optimistic assurances that were provided to the parents, Barnevernet, together with local police, forcefully removed the 5th and final child, baby Ezekiel, from the family home. As a non-tribunal government organization, Barnevernet held a hearing at its local office and ruled against the parents, accusing them of physically abusing their children, but without a single shred of evidence. They ordered an extensive medical examination of the children, but the results came back that there were no signs of physical or mental abuse. with absolutely no evidence, Van Evernet has upheld this decision solely on what it claims is the testimony of the children, a testimony that remains unproven and contradicts itself. Based on these unsubstantiated and unproven claims, Van Evernet has, since November 17th, decided, first, the parents can only see the still breastfeeding baby Ezekiel 2 times per week for only 2 hours at a time. Second, only Ruth is allowed to see her boys, Matthew and John, and only once a week. And third, neither parent has been allowed to see the girls until just a few days ago, when they were given 2 hours together before authorities took the girls back to their foster homes. Because the interrogation of the children was done without a lawyer present, it is unclear how they were interrogated, whether a psychologist was present, or how the testimony of the children was obtained. The lack of a lawyer representing the parents meant that it was impossible to ensure that rules and regulations governing interrogations of minors were honored, and that the interrogations proceeded in such a way as to avoid inflicting psycho-emotional trauma upon the children. Currently, the children are being unjustly held in 3 separate foster homes in 2 different cities, all of which are 3.5 hours away from the family home. It has been documented that the children insist they miss their parents and they want to return home, but Van Evernet continues to deny these pleas. On December 15th, Van Evernet told Marius and Ruth that although the organization wanted to get to know them better and reevaluate them in February 2016, they would nevertheless continue adoption proceedings for all 5 of the children. The methods used by Van Evernet have reminded us Romanians of the tactics employed by the former totalitarian communist regime of Romania. It is this recognition that sustains us in our justified accusations of Van Evernet and implicitly the Kingdom of Norway for its complicitly in and flagrant violation of family and human rights, of the threats and the intimidation tactics used against the Bonario family, of the use of Van Evernet's lawyers, some of which do not hold licenses to practice, and of attempts to silence and restrict religious freedom. We denounce the irrational and abusive actions against a normal and responsible family that has provided for a loving and prosperous environment in which to raise its 5 children. Marius and Ruth have proven that they are productive members of society and have added value to their community by the nature of their professions without ever having been involved in immoral or illegal acts. Marius and Ruth's parental, along with their collective family's rights, were grossly violated through this unwarranted confiscation of their children and the subsequent processes utilized by Van Evernet. Despite this gross abuse of power by Norwegian authorities, Marius and Ruth have transparently and openly complied with all investigations for the return of their children. Throughout this period of nearly 3 months, however, Norwegian authorities have employed intimidation tactics and overly excessive zeal to interrogate the children. They have asked leading questions designed to inculpate the parents and cover up any evidence supporting them in their defense against these irrational, extreme, and unsubstantiated allegations brought against them. The Bonarios are not, however, the only family that have experienced the unjustified proceedings of Van Evernet. Countless families from Lithuania, Poland, Slovenia, Turkey, Brazil, India, Russia, and the Czech Republic have also had similar experiences to that of the Bonarios. We have gathered here today with one purpose and one purpose alone. We stand in solidarity, in support of the reunification of Marius and Ruth Bonariu with their children, Eliana, Naomi, Matthew, John, and Ezekiel. Present here today are members of Bethel Romanian Church, Emmanuel Romanian Pentecostal Church, Southside Baptist Church, Abbotsford Pentecostal Church, Emmanuel Baptist Church, Agape Church, the Romanian Community Center, and the Holy Trinity Orthodox Church. We have united together to stand in peaceful protest before the Royal Norwegian Consulate General in Vancouver to send our message to Norway and the world that what has taken place via the Barnevernet authorities within the Bonaio family is an egregious assault on the rights of the family. Norway, return the children to Bonaio family.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, friends and colleagues, brothers and sisters. Today is a historic moment. It's a family day. It's a British Columbia statutory holiday. But it's not a holiday, it's not a joy in Norway for the Bonaio family. We are here to support the family of seven, the family of Marius and Ruth Bonaio from Nosdal, Norway. We are here in support the return of five children that were removed by force from their family on November 16, 2015 by Barnevernet. This is unimaginable acts in the modern times on the civilized society. Marius and Ruth Bonaio family is not alone. Other families are suffering as well from the careless acts of Barnevernet. Bonaio children were removed without investigation and without warnings, a clear violation of due process. We are gathered here today in support of the Bonaio family, who, as you all know, are gravely tried in a most horrible way. I would like to address the source of their ordeal directly and announce to the world why we are here. Barnevernet, today you are trying the court of public opinion on the world stage, and we point a guilty finger to you for human rights and abuses of the worst kind. In Norway, you are the judge, legislator, and executioner, and consider yourself above the law. But today, the table are reversed. You are accused of grave and unconscionable acts, crimes against the family, against children, against parents alike, leaving in your wake of trail of tears, pain, and untold suffering. You are found guilty of the crime of completely disregard due process. If it were some foreign concept of depriving a newborn of his mother nutrition milk, of ripping four children from the loving arm of their parents by forcing both parents and child to endure endless interrogations, just so they would admit to things that they never dream of, for having those children placed apart in three different locations, hundreds of miles and hours away, without any possible contacts, by forcing them to undergo unnecessary radiation while tersely pursuing proof of abuse but finding none, for threatening the parents that if they speak up they will never see their children again, for the purposely placing the children in faraway locations to discourage the parents to go and see them, for pretending to be blind and deaf to our protests, and the list goes on. The question is being to be asked, what was is that their parents were found guilty of until proven innocent, like your system operates? Was drugs? Was neglect? Was deplorable living condition? Was abuse? No. It's a resounding no. They only claimed crime then, raising their children in a Christian home, which was deemed to be dangerous by you, so much to that children were removed by force. You stand accused and found guilty by all standards of violating the moral law and godly law, of depriving the most basic of rights, both parents and child, thereby traumatizing them in unimaginable ways. There are empty beds and unused toys in the Bonaio home, waiting for the rightful member of the family to return. the damage is done, for the unspeakable pain and emotional stress the Bogmariu parents are going through that never can be imagined and cannot be undone and forgotten. However, this family and others who find themselves in similar situation will at least start to heal the day the children are returned home. And the right of the parents to raise their children in a Christian environment is affirmed. We will not stand silent by this and simply watch powerless while you insisting on continuing your destruction and devious practices. No, we will raise our voices. We will make sure we are heard, giving our voices to the voiceless and sharing in their pain, suffering and despair. You see, you touch the Bogmariu family and you touch all of us. Their suffering is our own. And we are here today to stand in solidarity with them and to show the world that a great injustice has been done. There can be no justice under your current system, your corrupt system that sees each child as a money-making opportunity has to fall. Make no mistake about it, Partner Bernetta. You are not going away. We will not rest and we will not fall silent. In fact, the longer time goes on, the more will dry out. Such despicable abuses will not be tolerated or accepted by any of us. Your guilty remains the longer you try to ignore us. The bond we have each other is unbreakable, unshakable, and you have never seen such a fury that we are prepared to unleash against you in sustained effort. All over the globe, tens of thousands of people are signing petitions, are protesting against these human and family rights violations. The family has always been the cornerstone from ancient to the modern society. For more than 6,000 years of proven history, the family was the place where the children were raised with unconditional love and care. And the leader are born there, sacred rights given by God, our Creator. The family values are so important, providing the true happiness, and it's worth to fight for it. There is nothing worse in this world than losing your children in the hands of the careless agency. Our God is an awesome God that will soften the hurt of those in position to make a favorable decision for Bogmariu family and will wipe away their tears. The past holiday should have been a great joy and quality time well spent like other family. However, for the Bogmariu family was endless suffering, tears and sadness. This is more than a family can bear. We strongly and respectfully request to the public authorities immediately return the five children to their parents and treat them with respect, dignity that they deserve. However, as long as it takes, we are prepared to go distance, so help us now. Amen.
Mulțumesc tuturor că ați avut curajul.
I thank you all that you have the courage
și demnitatea morală să fiți prezenți la acest protest pașnic.
And the moral responsibility to be present at this peaceful protest.
De susținere a familiei Bogmariu și celorlalte familii.
In supporting the Bogmariu family and all the other families.
Care trec printr-un timp de nedreptate.
Families that have experienced a time of injustice.
De durere și grele încercări.
Pain and difficult trials.
Apreciez.
I appreciate
că ați avut curajul să luptați împotriva răului.
That you had the courage to fight against evil.
a nedreptății,
against injustice,
a abuzului,
and the abuse,
comis de Organizația de Protecție a Copilului din Norvegia,
and the abuse committed by the Child Protection Organization from Norway.
Și nu numai,
but not it alone.
Astăzi aici în British Columbia, Canada.
Today here in British Columbia, Canada.
Sărbătorim Ziua Familiei.
We celebrate Family Day.
O zi dedicată să onoreze familia.
A day dedicated to honor the family.
O zi în care onorăm relația dintre părinți și copii.
A day in which we honor the relationships between parents and children.
Relația dintre frați și surori.
Relationships between brothers and sisters.
Astăzi în British Columbia.
Today in BC.
Ne oprim din lucru.
We stop from our work.
Ca să petrecem timp cu familia.
In that we may spend time with our family.
Cu copiii noștri cei dragi.
With our children.
Suntem onorați și binecuvântați.
We are honored and blessed.
Că guvernul a hotărât să prețuiască familia.
That the government has decided to value the family.
Și copii.
And children.
Și să protejeze dreptul copiilor împreună cu părinților.
And to protect the rights of children together with their parents.
Prin această acțiune declarăm public.
Through this action we declare publicly.
Convingerea noastră.
Our conviction.
Că familia,
that the family,
a fost creată de Dumnezeu,
was created by God,
fiind baza pe care se clădește o societate,
being the foundation on which a society is built.
Eu sunt aici,
I am here,
pentru că am crescut într-o familie frumoasă,
because I was raised in a beautiful family,
credincioasă,
a faithful family,
armonizată,
harmonious family,
cu părinți severi,
with strict parents,
dar iubitori,
that were loving.
Noi copii,
as children,
ne-am simțit în siguranță,
we felt safe.
De aceea,
and that is why,
credem în familia tradițională.
We believe in the traditional family.
Credem și susținem că familia este formată dintre un bărbat și o femeie.
We believe and uphold that the family is made up between a man and a woman.
Care își nasc și își cresc copiii împreună.
Which give birth and raise to children together, their own children.
Ca să transmită valorile lui Dumnezeu în rasa umană și în societate.
In order that they may transfer God's values in the human race and society.
Declarăm aici.
We declare today.
Copiii sunt ai noștri.
The children are ours.
Așa cum ne-a dăruit Dumnezeu.
In the way that God gave them to us.
Și nu ai statului.
And not to the state.
Ei nu sunt făcuți în laboratoarele statului.
They are not made in state laboratories.
Ci în familiile noastre.
But in our own families.
Iar dacă există familii,
and if there exist other families,
care nu doresc copii,
that do not want children,
să nu aștepte copii din pântecele mamelor noastre.
Do not expect the children from the womb of our own mothers.
Ci să-și trăiască fericirea așa cum și-au ales-o.
Rather they should live their happiness the way they chose.
Societatea comunistă în care am crescut,
the communist society in which we were raised,
ne-a luat averea,
took our fortunes,
pământul,
our land,
proprietățile,
our property.
De-abia am scăpat de ani grei de dictatură comunistă.
We barely escaped the hard years of communist dictatorship.
Și astăzi societatea seculară,
and today secular society,
vrea să ne ia cea mai mare valoare,
wants to take from us our greatest value,
copii,
our children,
fără să pună în calcul că prin acest proces ruinează familia și societatea.
Without realizing that through this process it will ruin the family and society.
Declarăm aici cu convingere și fermitate.
We declare here with conviction and firmness.
Că dacă ne luați haina, vă dăm.
Că But if you were to take our coat, we will give it to you.
Dacă ne luați locurile de muncă, ne căutăm altele.
If you were to take our places of work, we will search for others.
Dacă ne măriți taxele, nu ne place, dar le vom plăti.
If you raise our taxes, even though we don't like it, we will pay them.
Dar dacă ne luați copiii,
but if you take our children,
vom lupta pentru ei.
We will fight for them.
Și stăm ca un zid între ei și cei care au un plan să distrugă familia.
And we will stand as a wall between them and those that have in their plans destruction of the family.
Suntem aici să ne spunem opinia.
We are here to speak our opinion.
Crezul,
our creed,
și durerea,
and our pain.
Că în data de 16 și 17 noiembrie 2015,
that on 16th and 17th November 2015,
cei 5 copii ai familiei Bodnariu au fost luați de la părinții lor.
The 5 children of the Bodnariu family were taken from their parents.
De fapt au fost răpiți.
Were abducted.
Fără nicio justificare legală.
Without any legal and normal justification.
Și normală de către Barnevernet.
By the Barnevernet.
Organizație care se pretinde a fi una protectoare a copiilor din Norvegia.
An organization that pretends to be one that protects children in Norway.
Nimeni nu are dreptul să ne ia copiii noștri.
Nobody has the right to take our children away.
Cine ești tu, Norvegie și Barnevernet, să iei un copil de 3 luni sugar de la sânul mamei?
Who are you, Norway and Barnevernet, to take a 3-month-old child suckling at the mother's bosom?
Barnevernet, luând copiii de la mamă,
taking the children from their mothers,
distrugi!
You destroy
pasiunea de a fi mamă.
The passion of being a mom.
Luând copiii din casa unui tată iubitor și protector.
Taking the children from the loving and protective house of a father.
Care i-a născut.
That begot them.
Distrugi pasiunea de a fi tată.
You destroy the passion of being a father.
Distrugi familia.
You destroy the family.
Și distrugi societatea.
And you destroy the society.
Statisticile arată.
The statistics show.
Că rata criminalității,
at the rate of criminals,
este de 8 ori mai mare în rândul copiilor și adolescenților.
It's 8 times greater among children and adolescents that
care au fost luați din familiile lor naturale,
that were taken from the natural families,
și așezați în diferite plasamente,
and situated in different placements.
Protestăm.
We protest
împotriva oricărui abuz asupra copiilor.
Against any type of abuse against children.
Considerăm un abuz să răpești 5 copii din familia Bodnariu.
We consider an abuse to abduct 5 children of the Bodnariu family.
Și să împarți întregi familii.
And to split them up into 3 surrogate families.
La distanță de 350 de kilometri de familie.
At distances of 350 kilometers from each other.
Protestăm.
We protest.
Împotriva legilor care ascund realitatea ei sub afirmații că protejează copiii.
We protest against the legislation which hides its reality under affirmations that they are protecting the children.
Și care nu este în interesul copiilor.
That is not in the children's interest.
Se dovedește că este un dușman al copiilor și familiei.
But prove that it is a cruel enemy of the children and families.
Protestăm împotriva aroganței.
We protest against arrogance.
A lipsei de profesionalism.
Against the lack of professionalism.
A unora care reprezintă Barnevernet.
Of some that represent the Barnevernet.
Și a soluțiilor proaste.
And of the bad solutions.
Dureroase.
Painful solutions.
Inumane.
Inhumane solutions.
Alese de ei.
Chosen by them.
Protestăm.
We protest.
Că vă jucați cu viața oamenilor.
You are playing with the lives of people.
Și faceți experiențe pe ei.
And are experimenting on them.
Care duc în final la ruinarea societății.
Which in the end it will lead to the ruin.
În care voi trăiți.
In which you live.
Societatea în care voi trăiți a ajuns unde este astăzi.
The society in which you live today has arrived.
La un înalt nivel, standard de viață.
This high standard of living.
Pentru că au fost familii care au crescut.
Because there were families that have raised.
Și au educat copiii.
And educated their children.
Înaintașii voștri n-au fost copiii din înaintașilor voștri n-au fost răpiți.
The children from your ancestors were not
și n-au fost crescuți în familii surogate.
And not raised in surrogate families.
Protestăm.
We protest
împotriva abuzului dezvoltat în Norvegia de Barnevernet.
Against the
businessului dezvoltat în Norvegia de Barnevernet.
Against the business developed in Norway by the Barnevernet.
Pe baza
built on
abuzului asupra familiei și copiilor.
The abuse against children and the family.
Dreptul de proprietate asupra copiilor nu se cumpără cu bani.
The right of ownership to call children your own is not bought with money.
El este dat de natura umană.
It is given by human nature.
Și de Dumnezeu.
And by God.
Copiii sunt darul lui Dumnezeu pentru familie.
Children are the gifts of God for the family.
De aceea noi vindem.
And that's why we will not sell them.
Noi cumpărăm.
Or buy them.
Și vrem să-i creștem.
We wish to raise them.
Și să-i învățăm.
And teach them.
În așa fel încât societatea să se dezvolte și nu să se ruineze.
In such a way that our society is built up and not demolished.
Cerem.
We ask.
Consulatului care reprezintă regatul Norvegiei la Vancouver.
To the consulate that represents the kingdom of Norway in Vancouver.
Precum și ambasada regatului Norvegiei la Ottawa.
And the embassy of the kingdom of Norway in Ottawa.
Să ia măsuri de urgență pentru ca familia Bodnariu și celelalte familii care le-au fost confiscați copiii să se întoarcă cât mai grabnic în casa lor.
Kingdom of Norway, take emergency measures in order that the Bodnariu family and the other families that had their children adopted to have their children returned to them.
Cerem Norvegiei să stopeze abuzurile făcute de Barnevernet.
We ask Norway to stop the abuses that were done by the Barnevernet.
Cerem Norvegiei să respecte și să aplice legile și acordurile internaționale la care a subscris.
We ask Norway to stop the abuses that were done by Barnevernet. We ask Norway to respect and apply the international laws and accords to which they subscribe.
Cerem astăzi aici guvernului British Columbia.
We ask today that the government of British Columbia
și guvernului federal de la Ottawa
and the federal government from Ottawa
să nu accepte
not to accept
și să nu promoveze legi care sunt împotriva umanității
or promote laws that are against humanity
împotriva familiei tradiționale
against the traditional family
împotriva copiilor
against the children
și care se ducă la ruinarea familiei și a societății canadiene
which in the end will lead to the ruin of the family in the Canadian society
așa cum se întâmplă în Norvegia
as it is happening in Norway.
Aducem la cunoștința Norvegiei.
Bring to the knowledge of Norway.
Și a Canadei.
And Canada.
Și a lumii întregi.
The whole world.
Că nici o luptă împotriva lui Dumnezeu și a valorilor lui nu a fost câștigată.
And that not one battle against God and His values was ever won.
Ci dimpotrivă, cine și-a permis să se ridice împotriva lui Dumnezeu
and moreover anyone who allowed himself to rise up against God
a avut de suferit pierderi incalculabile
had to suffer incalculable losses.
Dumnezeu să lumineze Norvegia.
May God enlighten Norway.
Dumnezeu să binecuvinteze România.
May God bless Romania.
Dumnezeu să binecuvinteze Canada.
May God bless Canada.
Vă mulțumesc.
I thank you.
Căci Domnul vine.